Every great project begins with an idea and gains momentum as a common vision draws people together. The Burley Landscape Sage-Grouse Habitat Restoration Project is a long title for a project that has an impressive and growing list of partners with the lofty goal of protecting sage-grouse habitat.
This project is important for sage-grouse and rangeland health because sage-grouse depend on sagebrush steppe habitats that are being threatened by both juniper encroachment, fire, and development. And in this particular area, the development in the lower part of the valley and the pinching of the juniper coming down the mountain has rendered them to have a reduced habitat over historic levels. And so since we don't have the ability to re-establish sagebrush steppe in agriculture lands, our best way to increase the amount of habitat available for sage grouse is to treat these juniper encroachment areas.
A true picture of a collaborative partnership, the project highlights relationships between the BLM Idaho Burley Field Office, the Natural Resource Conservation Service, Idaho Department of Fish and Game, Pheasants Forever, and 37 permittee allotment holders. Over the past 4 years, the project has treated close to 10,000 acres and plans to treat another 22,000 acres in the next 3 to 5 years. Lek counts provide evidence that sage-grouse are returning to areas once overgrown with juniper.
In 2010, the NRCS implemented the Sage-Grouse Initiative, which was designed to help landowners improve sage-grouse habitat on their property.
Yeah, so this partnership is really unique in the fact that all the parties involved are necessary to complete this project. We're working on BLM lands, we're working on state lands, we're working on private lands, and really without everyone's cooperation, everyone's support of these projects, this project couldn't move forward. Just the permittees alone are a real catalyst to getting this work done on the ground, and without their support, we would be years in the future before this work could be accomplished.
Okay, about 5 years ago, this area behind me had probably 1,000 cedar trees, and this is an example of one that's been removed. And at the time that tree was here, this was basically bare, sterile soil around here. And now that it's gone, there's more water available, and you got this feed that's been able to grow up here, and it's made benefit for the wildlife as well as the cattle.
So these projects really benefit sage grouse, obviously, for the sole fact that they're addressing a very specific threat to the bird, which is encroaching juniper. But the project goes well beyond that, and it really improves the health of the range and the ecosystem. Sage grouse rely heavily on large, intact acres of healthy native range grounds. And what these projects allow us to do is they allow us to restore those range grounds back to a historic state when the bird readily used the land.
The expansion of juniper is a natural process normally controlled by fire. However, fire suppression efforts over the years may have allowed expansion in areas not historically occupied by juniper. Wildfire is currently the foremost threat to sustaining grouse populations in Idaho.
So the area behind me is Cedar Knoll, and looking at a 1940 aerial photo, we've noticed that there was still juniper present. So when we tackled the implementation of this project, we wanted to make sure there was juniper still left on the ground, stuff that was probably naturally and historically there. So we tried to do more of a mosaic pattern, something that fire would do if it was to burn through this ecosystem. And we're trying to just focus on those areas that juniper was starting to move into the sagebrush steppe and try to reduce that encroachment, push back those encroachment areas.
As livestock operators, I think we've shown our critics that we are willing to do things, positive things, to help the sage grouse.
In my opinion, and I'm a little biased, I think the partnership that we've created to do this may be the most important thing to come out of it. You know, I mean, we've all kind of come together with a common goal. We've brought our strengths. We've helped our partners, you know, offset some of their weaknesses, and really created something that, you know, we're looking at replicating in other parts of the state. And we're also hearing from some of our neighboring states they're kind of peeking over the fence and seeing what's occurring, and I think they're going to try, you know, doing some of this work in their states.
Improving sage-grouse habitat fulfills BLM's policy to manage special status species and their habitats to prevent their listing under the Endangered Species Act.